Hello everybody, welcome to today's video. Today I'm going to talk about three interesting and important things about data analytics, data science, whichever way you call it. Okay, the first thing, you talk to any data scientist or data analytics individual, the most typical response is that, hey, I love my work, I really enjoy what I'm doing, and I'm also learning a lot. We'll deep dive into why that is actually the case. Okay, number two, I'll talk about the entry requirements for being a data analyst or a data scientist. By the way, a quick tip, there are no such kind of entry requirements for data analytics jobs. Okay, we'll talk about how you can improve your profile. Number three, what are the exit opportunities for data scientists? I don't think you have come across any such video where you talk about, hey, after data scientist, what are the next steps for you, right? So we'll talk through that particular aspect as well. So we'll go through into each one of these topics and then see what are your views and are you really ready to get into this particular career stream. Before we jump into the actual discussion, I just want to say that, hey, before joining McKinsey, I was a data analytics analyst myself. So I did a lot of statistical modeling, I did a lot of number crunching, I worked for Mu Sigma, one of the top data analytics organizations out there. Super grateful for the opportunity and really thank all the leadership over there for giving me that opportunity. I completely believe that, hey, wherever I am today is because of that particular stepping stone itself. Okay, without any further delay, let's jump into the first one. Why do data analytics professionals say that, hey, their work is interesting? Let's take, for example, what happened during the IPL. Swiggy, Zomato, Uber, Paytm, these guys were coming up with ads after ads after ads. I don't even remember how many ads I have seen for Swiggy and Zomato. Probably thousands of ads just during the IPL season, right? Now, if you are working for Swiggy, what do you want to know? Do you want to know that, hey, yes, I've spent hundreds of crores on this marketing budget. Am I getting actually more orders on my app or no? Correct? This is the thing that you want to know. Similarly, you want to know if you're working for Uber, hey, I've spent so much money. Are actually people using Uber or booking the app because of these advertisements or not? So you as a data analytics individual working in that particular team, you will start crunching numbers. You will start building statistical models to understand that, hey, whether your marketing budget went for a toss or your marketing budget actually helped you book some sales. These are the kind of interesting things that data scientists, data analysts are doing on a day-to-day basis. Now, let's pick probably an even more interesting example, right? Google has so much of data. We all go search on Google probably for 100 times every single day. So what Google did was, hey, with all the kind of data you are typing in, it started to understand whether this particular text can be automatically generated even without you type the full sentence. Who is behind generating these kind of algorithms? It is data scientists and data analytics, right? So Google, Swiggy, Paytm, you pick any startup company, you pick any big company, right? Hey, Visa, MasterCard, how many Visa transactions happen in a day? How many MasterCard transactions happen in a day? Who has the answer? The answer is coming from these data scientists and data analytics guys. How can they improve the number of transactions? They have the answers. So it's the combination of the tools that they use, right? SQL, Python, R, SAS, bunch of these things in conjunction with the business knowledge that they are developing makes this entire job super fruitful and very, very, very interesting. Now, if I jump into the other aspect of data analytics, right? What are the entry requirements for these jobs? And even before entry requirements, who is hiring for these jobs? As I mentioned, I worked for Mu Sigma Analytics. Similarly, there is Fractal Analytics. There is Latent View Analytics. Then there is Dell. Then there is Swiggy. Swiggy has a huge analytics team, by the way. Okay. Zomato has a huge analytics team, by the way. You take any of these companies, Microsoft, all these companies are currently hiring for data analytics roles. And the beauty of it is that they say we don't require any prior experience. Then how do you know that whether this is a good thing or not for you? Well, if you love solving puzzles, if you love solving, let's say, data interpretation questions in CAT examination, right? This is the perfect job for you. Let me repeat, you love solving puzzles or you love solving data interpretation problems in CAT examination, right? This is the perfect job for you. If you don't have any prior experience, if you are an undergrad student or an MBA student, right? How do you then go about it? Don't think about your next degree in this particular space, but rather you should think about what are the ways in which you can build your portfolio. portfolio in the sense that, hey, log on to any of the Indian government portals and you will get a lot of data related to the number of COVID patients in the last 2 years, right? Get the total number of people who are tested positive in the last 2 years at a daily level. If you can get that, get it at an hourly level as well. Get this data and see that, hey, whether it's a weekday or a weekend, see what is the temperature of that particular day on average in different cities. See what are the festivals around those particular dates. Can you see if there are any relationships between these particular COVID cases and these all these different variables, right? That will start telling you that, hey, patterns are visible in the data if you just take one step ahead and start looking for them. Not just skimming through the data, but if you actually look for patterns, you will find patterns in data. And start building small models and then gradually move to SQL and then slowly move into R, then move into SAS, these kind of platforms, right? Along with that, on the side, if you're looking at, hey, why the COVID number of deaths is impacted by festivals or impacted by, let's say, any other factor, understand the reason behind it. Now go start read the articles and understand why this is happening. You start combining these two things, you can walk into any interview with a lot of confidence and say that I know how to analyze data and I also know how you have to make decisions based on this particular data. Both these things are super critical and you don't need to get these skills just from any specific degree. You can get these skills by your own practice from different websites or reading through the news or making sure that, hey, you're up to date with respect to what is happening in the current dynamic world. Okay, just make sure you do these things right and you can apply to some of these companies and your career next steps are a lot dependent on what you can do right now in your voluntary and free time. The third interesting thing that I also want to talk about is what are the potential career paths for data analytics individual? I'm not sure if you have come across anything where, hey, what are the career paths for data analytics individuals? Isn't it pretty straightforward that, hey, if you're a data scientist now, you'll probably be a senior data scientist in a couple of years, and then probably you'll become a director in the same company. So what is the career path that you're talking about? Well, it is interesting and important for you to know that, because what I did from my personal experience was, as a data analytics guy, I started learning a lot about the technology tools and also a bit about the business background. When I applied to my MBA schools, I said that, hey, I already have understanding of the data. Now I want to come to INSEAD and I want to learn about the business concepts so that probably these two skills will help me take my career one step forward. So it is very easy for you to narrate a very, very strong story if you are coming from this data analytics kind of a background. So it really helps you in pushing your application for some of these top business schools abroad. Number two, what do you do as a management consultant? You are essentially getting some data and you are solving that data to get to that final insight, right? You can't go into a boardroom or you can't go to a client and say that, by the way, I believe that this is what you should be doing based on my prior experience. No, those kind of insights are out of place. They don't exist anymore. The clients are looking forward to you to get to an insight based on some kind of data analytics or some kind of real facts and figures out there. So all the consultants, entry level, junior level consultants are always working on data. So you already have that kind of advantage because you know how to work with data and you also know a bit about generating those business insights, right? So consulting is a very clear next step for a lot of data scientists. And to be honest, a lot of my friends from Mu Sigma have moved to some of the top consulting firms in the world, including me, right? That's number two. Number three, of course, you can move into the industry. You probably start with a specialized data analytics firm and then you move into the industry. For example, Dell, Microsoft, Facebook, Google, all these companies are looking for data analytics and data science professionals. Where you started without any background, without any experience, pulling up data from government websites and building your portfolio, and you are thinking about jobs in Google, Facebook, and a bunch of these big companies, right? And that entire career path is actually possible. I have seen folks who have made these kind of transitions in the long run. So it's a very interesting thing. The first option is business school. The second option is consulting. The third option is industry. And the final option is, of course, settling down in the same career path, right? You can become like an expert in statistical modeling. You can become a statistician, right? You can spend a lot of time building models itself. Hardcore data scientist, right? All these data scientist exit opportunities are in front of you. So think about this particular career. We talked about three interesting things. I hope these interesting things have at least helped you to think about the next steps in data science career. Number one, hey, what are the exit opportunities? Number two, what are the entry requirements? And number three, why is it interesting to get into data science? All right, guys, if you want me to talk more about data science going forward, please do drop in a note. I just want to keep this at a very high level. But if you want me to explore into any one aspect of the data science industry itself, please do come in and I'll be more than happy to talk about it going forward. Everything based on my experiences itself. Thank you so much, guys, and we'll again see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye.